going to go ahead and get started with the aeroponics class. For those who don't know me, my name is Dennis with Garden Pool. And aeroponics is probably the most popular page we have on our website. We get thousands of hits every week because people are very interested on how to clone plants or how to grow plants without soil, without water, just with mist. So that's what aeroponics is. It's kind of like growing with air, aero. So this bucket I designed just for this class today. And I'm actually really excited about this design. It's cheaper, easier to handle than my previous design. So this design is the very popular one. This is a regular old tote, like a Rubbermaid tote. We have these holes in it, and these are net pots. With these neoprene foam rubber lids, and I cut the bottom off the net pots. Stick it in here, and then water just sprays. And I'm talking just water. So this is what we have inside of this aeroponics unit. We have 6 sprinkler heads. They're 180s, so they just spray this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, and a simple fountain pump, and this one does have the pre-filter, because I don't want anything clogging these very fine heads, okay? And that's it. This uses about 7 watts of electricity. Stick it in here. Plug this into a timer. But with this model, I actually had to seal this with silicone all the way around. And then I say, please do not open. And every tour, someone would open it. So what I'll do from here is I'll plug this into our timer. And we have a waterproof indoor-outdoor timer made by West Tech. A 3-prong, plug it in, and I'll set it for 30 minutes on and 30 minutes off. And all we have in here is water, just enough to bury that pump in water. No nutrients, no anything. So as it's set up like this, it's a cloning machine. I can take this beautiful tomato plant and make 8 more clones of this plant that are ready to produce fruit in 2 weeks. That's awesome. It would take me 3 months to do that from seed. So I can clone almost every type of vegetable. No. Name a vegetable, I can clone it. I've even cloned a leaf of lettuce one time, guys. I actually, over here, we have a grapevine, a mulberry tree, some Cuban oregano, and some water spinach. And these puppies are cloned. I'm gonna get sprayed. But look at the roots, it's ready to transplant. It's ready to go. So usually it takes about 2 weeks. The water on this just covers the pump. So there's maybe 1.5 gallons of water in here. But this bucket version's better. For the major reason is, this is made out of food-grade plastic. This is not. So this is just a cloning machine. We don't grow to harvest. Well, let's say... Well, let's say I want to grow this to harvest. I'll just have to add some hydroponic solution in here. And So Honeyville bucket has that seal on it. So once you jam it down, you don't have to add any silicone. It's food grade. So I took my drill. You need one tool. And you hold it straight up and down. It's got a little pilot hole. Do it as fast as you can go, slowly, and let this do all the work. Okay, don't try to push it or it'll crash it like that. So straight down. So this is 2 3/4 inches, and these are 3-inch net pots. And then they have the foam rubber lids. But on the net pots, I just cut the bottoms out so that the roots can go through. Because I'm gonna transplant, I'm gonna take these out and plant them in here or plant them somewhere else. But if I wanna go to harvest, I can. You can see the leaves are just starting to turn yellow, right? Because there's no nutrients in here. These plants are gonna starve, but they have roots. So, let's take a cutting here. When we take a cutting, it's actually a surgical procedure. And what I mean by that is that if I cut with this blade, I don't even know how to get this sucker open. If I cut with that blade, it'll probably infect these guys. Think about it. Would you want to be cut open with that blade for a surgery?
No.
So I have my scissors, which have been disinfected. Here we go. So how do I disinfect the scissors? With rubbing alcohol. Okay. I like to use those rubbing alcohol wipes. They're real handy. So I disinfected this. And anyone watch The Walking Dead last Saturday?
Oh, yeah.
You see old man Herschel out there?
Yeah.
What he did, he just took one off and stuck it in the ground. He's like, those hairs will turn to roots. He don't know what he's talking about. It'll probably die. Because you're sticking it in the ground.
So we just pinch it off here. Things break, but they can still grow. These little bristles, they'll take root. We'll have a whole new plant.
A lot of bacteria, a lot of yucky stuff in there. I stick it in the air and let the mist spray it, so it's sterile, nice and sterile. So what I'm looking for when I take a cutting is these are branches. They're also called nodes. I want to have a couple of branches. And I'll just take a nice cutting at a 45. Try to get one clean sweep, okay? Now, I'm gonna cut off one of these branches and cut off the flowers and any buds I see, because we're not trying to grow fruit right now, guys. We're just trying to grow stems.
Why the 45? More surface area?
Uh-huh, more surface area. And I'm looking, no more buds. Now, tomatoes are like the most sensitive plant in the world, okay? It'll probably wilt. They got all these hairs which are actually kind of like feelers. So, let's take out one, put a new one in here. Let's cut this out. Spray.
What are you spraying on it?
So, okay. So, the trick is to get your neoprene net pot lid around it, like Pac-Man, it bites it, okay? You don't want to jam it up, it doesn't like to be touched, okay? And then as you put it in your net pot, it kind of cinches it in. But this neoprene's pretty neat stuff. Sometimes roots will even grow into it, so the plants don't mind it at all. And then I just put it in the water, and that's it. In 1 week, I should see little short roots. In 2 weeks, transplant size roots. And you can go into dirt or you can go into soilless grow medium. So this isn't just for hydroponics or aquaponics. It's for any other gardener who wants to have tomato plants real quick. This is what they do at the greenhouse in the nursery when they sell plants. They're all clones. They don't start these guys from seed.
Dennis.
Yes?
How far would you want the roots to grow if you're going to do it?
Well, it really doesn't matter. You're looking for a full set of roots that can support the plant.
So like that would go in there?
Usually about like this long. Yeah, the ones that I brought out that are real long, they're ready to go in. Soilless or otherwise. But the roots have to be big enough to support the plant.
Can't they be too big? Where they're being all wound up in a tight
space?
Yeah,
well, if Let me tell you what, if I left this tomato plant in here and I kept adding solution so it didn't die, big plant, thing full of roots, it'll be like swirl around the bucket and everything. So yeah, you're looking at a couple of weeks and you want about a foot long roots. After that, they just kind of get too large to deal with, especially with aquaponics, because our soil, this grow medium, is not that deep usually. So
when you plant the root, you've got that 12 inches of string. You're going to jam them all together?
It's okay. It's just fine. It's just happy to be planted and to be getting some nutrients now, because it's been kind of starving for a couple of weeks. But after that 2 weeks, it should just flower right up. As long as you plant outside, it, flowers will just happen. You don't have to add anything special to kick it into flowering. It'll just go. So you can't do this successfully with every type of tomato, though. There's two types of tomatoes, interdeterminate and determinate. What's the difference and how do I remember? Determinate have a determined fate, meaning they're going to give their fruit and die. Okay, Romas, yellow Asian pears, they give you the tomatoes and the plant dies. They're bush varieties, bush tomatoes. We like to get the indeterminate tomatoes. This is indeterminate, meaning it's a vining tomato plant. It'll just keep giving fruit and keep growing. So in theory, this mother plant, as long as I take care of it properly, should last me forever, and I should always have clones coming off of it. So I always look for the strongest, healthiest looking mother plant to take cuttings from, because the babies are going to be just like her. Genetically identical, they're literally identical twins. And this one is as old as this one, meaning in 2 weeks, when this starts flowering and fruiting, I'll have tomatoes on it, which is great. So you guys probably heard about that, the biggest hothouse with hydroponic tomatoes. I think it's down in Winslow, I'm thinking. They do hydro, they do indeterminate tomatoes, and they just keep binding those suckers up, pull the fruit, just keep going and going and going for a very long time. And as long as you keep bacteria out of here, you're fine. So I only teach this class when it cools off. I'm not going to teach this class at the beginning of May or July or June because it's too hot outside. You'll set this on your patio. The water temperature is going to be like 80 degrees, and it's going to be like a jacuzzi for bacteria in here, okay? So we're not adding chlorine or anything like that. So once this time of weather kicks in, once it's nice outside, I'm cloning until it's hot again. But I never run out of tomato plants, never run out of sweet potatoes. Just take a cutting. Bam, you're good to go.
So they were on your roof?
We have a couple hundred, or we have 100 tomato plants on our roof. It's hooked up to our pool, water zigzags, and goes back down.
Your house cool a little bit too?
Actually, it helps create a good microclimate. And our roof in general cut our electric bill 20%. So it's a cool roof, literally. Introduced star rating and all that. But cloning, I guess you can really appreciate cloning aeroponics way if you've ever cloned traditional gardening way. So let me tell you how the other guys do it, and you'll appreciate why I do it this way. Let's say I'm a soil gardener, dirty hands and all, and I want to clone this, okay? So what I'll do is I'll do the exact same thing I just did. Nice clean cut. I have a couple of nodes. Now I've actually cloned these too, that you can break off. You can clone those too. So there is no waste if you don't, if you have the room. But I think that's okay. Now, if I'm going to clone this with soil, traditional gardening methods, you have your root hormone powder, right? You dump this out on a plate, you stick this in there, you put it in a little pea pot or something with nothing, you know, peat's usually what they use. And then, it's the game. You got to mist it. 6, 7, 8, 9 times a day. You don't want these leaves to dry out until it grows roots. Takes maybe, you know, 3 or 4 weeks. You miss it one time, it's dead. If it dries out, it's dead. So people actually build sprinkler boxes and stuff, but it's very hard to control because you can't get the soil too wet. The soil's got to be dry for the roots to grow. So it's a very labor-intensive thing. That's why I love this. Just take a cutting, pop it in there, forget about it. Come back 2 weeks later, you're good to go. So I've seen commercial units Think about this footprint. They're tall. They go for like $500-$600. You know, I built this. What is this, like $8 for this bucket? And I probably have maybe another $20 in parts. I can build how many of those for $500? Just like that something garden.
So it mists constantly or just every 30 minutes?
Real good aeroponic system should be 30 minutes on, 30 minutes off. Because you need the roots to dry out a little bit, but not bone dry at all. Just enough to absorb a little bit of oxygen. But you don't have to add a bubble stone in here. You don't have to have anything. So let me teach you how I built this guy, what's inside, okay? Because it's a lot simpler than this one. It has like 80% less parts. And you can still get a lot of plants in here. So it's a pretty good deal. So like I said, this is one of those Honeyville buckets that once you cinch down, you kind of got to break it off because it's a food storage bucket. Just enough to cover the pump. No nutrients. Now, if you really want roots quickly, the only nutrient I ever suggest adding is vitamin B12. Just a little bit. That's the vitamin that makes us happy. Or vitamin B1, excuse me, I'm thinking of happy pills or something. Vitamin B1, just a little bit, and that's the only thing you would ever need besides tap water. And when I say tap water, I literally the tap water, but I let it go for a day. That way the chlorine's evaporated, because that will stress your plants out. But
what if you didn't use tap water?
I don't use root hormone at all. So you don't have to use any of the rooting gel or anything like that. And look how white these roots are. That means it has absolutely no infection at all. If it's warmer, then sometimes the roots kind of look brown. Plant's gonna die. So this is wonderful. This is water spinach. You can get it at the Asian markets. See, now this grape just started shooting roots. But hey, this will be 20 foot next year. The only thing you can't grow vegetable-wise is something with a woody stem in the system. So grapes next year would be too old because that would have a woody stem. The Persian mulberry tree, it was it wasn't woody stem yet, so I can clone it. This Cuban oregano, which is cool. It's got some roots on. Another week or so for this guy. And then this guy doesn't have nothing yet. But I'm going to go ahead and walk this around. This pump's really stuck in here. And just show you guys. It's a fountain pump with a 12-inch riser, just like you get for sprinklers, and a little 360 sprinkler head.
What kind of sprinkler heads are you using?
Plastic ones. I stay away from any brass, things like that.
Main bird right out of the Home Depot?
Yeah. Yep, as long as it's not PVC. So. Yeah, sure, go ahead. This is the simplest aeroponics kit in the world.
Is it about $25, right?
Yeah, for the whole thing, $25. And like I said, if you want to grow to harvest in here, you can. You just have to add hydro solution to it.
How well can you mix the aeroponics and the aquaponics?
I've tried. I haven't had any luck, my friend, because the fish waste, you really need to gunks it up. And I've tried using a settling tank and all of that. No luck yet. But if you don't want to use hydroponic solution, and let's say you're just growing lettuce to harvest, you can use your fish tank water. If you know, with aquariums, you're supposed to empty them out once a month or so, get the gravel filter, put it in here. That should be more than enough nitrogen to go to harvest. So, simplest project I ever built. And this is a food safe, plant safe, horticultural breed pump.
So you want the spraying to be a certain number of inches from all of your root system? Or?
Basically, it doesn't matter how far up and down the sprinkler head is, as long as the water, when you take one of these off, comes out. Or you put your hand in there and you feel the water. You don't want to have any dead spots. So this one in the middle, I put the longest stem I have because it shoots fan ways, so it goes down. So I put my long grapevine in the middle. So other than that, we get full coverage on here, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 grow sites. So, in 1 square foot of footprint, I can clone 7 plants. It's awesome, pretty good. If I wanted to, I could even put it, I almost did it, put a tomato cage right here, kind of like this, you know, just drill 3 holes, and then you can take the vining tomatoes to full harvest.
How many in a bucket that size?
7.
But to full harvest, too?
Yep. Now, the thing with soilless growing is you're thinking of, like this guy. This guy already has roots this large. Roots only grow when the dirt dries out. So when the dirt dries out, the roots grow and they search for water. So in soilless, whether it's hydro or aquaponics or aeroponics, it doesn't really focus on that. For the most part, the roots as big as the footprint of the plant. Now, I've had a hibiscus in a 5-gallon bucket for
4 years.
Now that sucker has gone all the way around. You know, but that's something that we'll never harvest. But for most veggies that you'll harvest, you can do a broccoli full cycle. Now, let's say you want to start from seed, you can. If you want to harvest in here, you'll just get the net pots, but you won't cut the bottoms off. I cut the bottoms off so I can take the plants out without destroying the roots for cloning purposes. But if you left the bottom on of the net pot, fill this up with coconut or expanded clay pellets. Coconut, really, because it wicks. You put your seeds in there, or you can do seed starts, and then you're good to go. The neat thing is for the first couple of weeks, you won't even need any nutrients if you're starting from seed. But if you want to go to full harvest, and if you're going to add some hydroponic solutions, some compost tea, you're going to have to add new water, probably every 3 weeks or so. So dump the water out, add new water, it's only a gallon, and add 1 teaspoon of this stuff. And that's it. Pretty easy. And I feel very confident in you guys growing this because this is food grade. You know, this really ultimately should be a cloning machine because this isn't food grade plastic. But who cares? It's only in there for a couple of weeks. Just to clone, and once again, it's not drying out and it's moist. So, they do have like cloning gel. But I don't recommend this stuff. If you look very carefully, it says rapid robust roots cutting. But if you look very finely, it says not for food crop use. So, hey, all you need is some water, and you can clone your plants. That's pretty easy. That's pretty easy. I've cloned some really fine plants. Like my friend Alex gets vanilla vine, you know, and he gives it to me because he knows I have the vanilla vine green thumb, and I'll clone it for him. But I only do it this time of year. I won't do it in summertime because I know even in my house it's probably too hot for this guy. You know, really water temperature, you don't want any hotter than like 70 degrees or something. You know, they do sell water chillers. It's kind of like has like a radiator kind of thing, and it just chills the water. You can get those at hydro stores, so you can clone all year round if you want. But
Dennis,
yes.
How low can the water go next to those systems?
Just cover the pump. You just don't want the pump.
No, I mean temperature-wise.
Oh, as long as it's not freezing. Yeah. Lower the water, it's pretty easy to grow with. It holds more oxygen. It's not a problem as long as you're not putting freezing water. But then again, we've had some pretty cold water on our roots in wintertime. I haven't had any problems. I mean, if the plant will survive with that temperature, then it will survive. More worried about the opposite end. Now at my house, what I put in here is a UVC light. It just kind of kills everything, so I never dump it out, but most people don't have that. So just dump it out in between clonings. So clone for a month, then dump your water out, because you might have some bacteria in there even if it's cold. And then just start again.
If you ever did have to clean it out, would you have to worry about what kind of soap you used to make sure it wasn't toxic?
I actually don't ever use soap. Good question. What I use is 1/10 bleach, you know, 1 to 10 parts of bleach. Just kind of put it in there. It's chlorine, so it actually will evaporate and spray it out real good.
Hydrogen peroxide
works fantastic as well. That's a good cleaner as well. Probably more safe because all you have there is oxygen bubbles.
Right.
They even have food grade hydrogen peroxide too. Or just leave this open in the sun, UV sterilize it. So one thing that can happen once it starts getting warmer, then you can't leave it in here for that long, the plants, because the roots will start to turn brown. That means you have bacteria in there. And then those fine roots kind of get junked up in your pump. That's why I recommend getting the pumps with the pre-filter. It has like that black foam stuff. Normally, like these guys, I don't use pre-filter for aquaponics because I want all the fish waste stuff. But for this guys, I don't want to clog up our sprinkler heads. So this one I can build in about 45 minutes. We have a class online with all of the parts to do it. But boy, I didn't know, I didn't think about this the first time.
What do you think about the differences between this aeroponics and a deep water, like a bubbler, deep water culture?
The airstone and all that? They have their pros and cons. I like this because it's versatile. You can clone in it, so that's super. But deep water culture is a very simple way to get started with hydroponics. You can do a 5-gallon bucket just like this. They make 5-gallon net pot lids just for 5-gallon buckets. You throw your coconut in there, fill it up with water right here, put a bubble stone on the bottom, that's a nutrient solution. Get started for $35. Pretty good, easy way to go. This one's just a little more versatile for me. Plus it's lighter. You know, I go around the places, classes and stuff. It's just, this thing, once it's made and filled, it's kind of immovable. You know, so I love this thing. So. Any more questions?
You think you can use the fish tank water to put it in there?
Yeah.
Okay, how often are you supposed to change that water?
Well, this one you're not supposed to change it. But okay, if you just had a tank by itself without aquaponics, you're supposed to change your fish tank at least once a month, right? Use those gravel filters so you get all that stuff from the bottom. Just put that right in here. That's nitrogen-rich water. If you're growing primarily heavy nitrogen feeders like your leafy lettuces and stuff, it'll do just great. It's great. It's kind of like fish meal, you know, the stuff they put in here. This is garden pool in a bottle, I think. It has, you know, just kind of like what we have. It's really natural stuff.
Yeah.
Took me a while to finally trust the hydro company.
Where do you get the pots?
The pots you can get any of the hydroponic shops. You know, I like 3-inch net pots. And just make sure you have the right size hole saw. Every little fitting I have my special hole saw for. So. That's just it. And when I do go to choose a hole saw, I take this with me, the part that goes inside, go to Home Depot, and just say, okay, that's like a perfect fit. That's what I want. So that's what I do. But, you know, I built this one in, I think, about 7 minutes. Five times, you know, as quick as building this, so.
Would you say you don't use PVC for a certain reason?
There's
like
no PVC in here at all. So, just the black plastic and horticultural pumps. You want to make sure you use horticultural pumps if you're growing to harvest, especially because the pumps might be from China. They might use lead solder or something like that. Lead is the last thing we want in our food. But other than that, I feel very confident, especially these honeybill buckets. They look nice. Food grade. And the thing I like about these honeybill buckets is they have that gasket seal. So it's real strong. You don't have to add any silicone or anything funky like that. So it's just food grade stuff in contact with water, and just a little bit of water, maybe a gallon and a half or so. That's about it. So, no more questions? I have the complete blueprints and instructions for this unit here. I will be posting the blueprints on this unit here as well. You got the handout. It gives you the web address. Plus, we have the video for the last time I built these, so you can watch me build them. I'll walk you through it. But the blueprints will be on here for this one probably next week sometime. Thank you guys. Appreciate it.